We are taking R.D. Sharma Solutions, Class 11, Chapter 1, Sets. Exercise is 1.4. The first question is, which of the following statements are true? Give reason to support your answer. The first question is that for any two sets A and B, either A is a proper subset of B or B is a proper subset of A. Is it true or not? Actually, it is false. Because the information is not fulfilling, or it is not complete. That is, A and B, they may not be comparable at all. They may not be comparable at all. So that is why it is false. Second is, every subset of an infinite set is infinite. See, if you take an infinite set of natural number, so it starts from 1 and it goes up to infinity. But if you take just 1, means one set, it is finite. So that is false. That means the every subset of an infinite set is not infinite. It can be finite also. Next one is, every subset of a finite set is finite. So when we have a finite set, this set, if we take a subset, then it will be finite. So this is true, because the order or the cardinality or the number of elements are known. And when we take a subset, it will be lesser than the actual elements here. So it will also be countable. Fourth one is, every set has a proper subset. See, we have an empty set called phi and it has no proper subset. So it is false. Next is, the question is like this. A, B, A, B, A, B, dot, dot, dot. This is an infinite set. In set theory or making a set, the repetition is allowed. So we can write this as A, 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 all these are A, and B, 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 1B. So now this becomes a finite set because repetition is allowed. So this becomes false. Next is A, B, C and 1, 2, 3 are equivalent sets. A, B, C and 1, 2, 3 are equivalent set. And this is true. Why? Because the count, you just count the number of elements here, 1, 2, 3. So they are three elements, 1, 2, 3, they are three elements. When the element number are same, they are called equivalent sets. Next is, a set can have infinitely many subsets. This is false. Why? Because whenever we have a set of, say, cardinality or number of elements as n, then we have a proper number, or we have a proper set which is called a power set, and the number of elements in this power set or this number of subsets that can be formed from the actual set is 2 to the power n. So this becomes false then. That is, a set can have infinitely many subsets. No, it is defined. It can have only this much of subsets. Next one is, state whether the following statements are true or false. So 1 belongs to 1, 2, 3. This is correct, because this is an element and it belongs to 1, 2, 3. It is here. Next one is, A is a subset of B, C, A. See, A is an element here. So you can write belong. You can write belong. You cannot write a subset, because if you want to make a subset, take this A out, put a brace here. Now this is a subset. But A as an element, it belongs to this set. It is not a subset. Third one is like this. A belongs to A, B, C. Now this is also false. Why? Because this is a set and we have an element A here. We don't have something like this. So if it has to belong to this set, it has to be like this. But when we are saying A belong to, that is, this braces of A, set belong to A, it is not there. Next one is, A, B is equal to A, comma A, comma B, comma B, comma A. So this repetition is allowed. So we can just write it as 1A and BB is 1B. So they are two equal sets. So this is true. This equality sign holds. Next one is, the set X is such that X plus 8 equal to 8 is the null set. So X plus 8 equal to 8, that is X equal to 8 minus 8, that is 0. So x is equal to 0. So there is an element in this set which is 0. It is not a null set. It has an element called 0 here. It is false. Next is decide among the following sets which are subsets of which. So we have A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D are there. So we have x square minus 8x plus 12. So let us try to make the factors. X square minus 8x can be written as minus 2x minus 6x plus 12. Take x common, x minus 2 minus 6 common, x minus 2 equal to 0. So x minus 6 into x minus 2 equal to 0. So you get x equal to 2 and 6. So this set is 2 and 6 or 6 or 2 you can write. Now you see this C is the biggest set because it is infinite. Dot 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 means it goes up to infinity. So this is the biggest set. So you have C here. This is a C set. Then we have the next one, which is 2, 4, 6. It is lying, you can see 2, 4, 6 here. So now we have a set called B, which contains 2, 4, 6 out of all these. Then we have a set A, which is 2, 6, and 2 is there and 6 is there. So we have a set which is BC. Now we have this one, A. And finally, we have this 6, which is belonging to everyone, and this one also. So you can say it is inside this, it is A. So I may write that this D, first of all we have to write the bigger one. So C is the highest one. So we can write D, this D is a subset of, D is a subset of A. This is D, internal, is a subset of A. Then A is a subset of B and B is a subset of C. So this is how we are going to write. Next one is write which of the following statements are true. You have to justify your answers also. The first one is the set of all integers is contained in the set of all rational numbers. So set of all integers, that is Z. What are these integers? 0, 1, 2 like this, infinite. Minus 1, minus 2 like infinite. So this is the Z. Then we have the rational number. So if you take any of these, say take 1, it can be written as 1 by 1. Say minus 2. Minus 2 can be written as minus 1 by 1. So this becomes rational also. So if you say that m belongs to some element, you take any of the element from this series or this z integer. If m belongs to z, then m always can be written as m by 1 as I just showed you, which is of p by q form, which is a rational number. Okay, q should not be equal to 0. So this implies that if m belongs to z, m also belongs to q. There is a rational number, it can be always written. So m belongs to z implies m belongs to q. That means z is a proper subset of q. And this z is an integer and q is the rational number. Next is the set of all crows is contained in the set of all birds. Yes, crow is a bird, so it is true. Then the set of all rectangles is contained in the set of all squares. No, this is false. These two, like rectangle and square, they come under a series, or you can say a set called quadrilateral. And square is a special type of rectangle where length and breadth are equal. So this statement is false. Next one is the set of all real numbers is contained in the set of all complex numbers. And this is true. Why? We have Z, which is the complex number. It can be written as X plus IY. It is written as X plus IY. IY. X is a real part and Y is the imaginary part. Now you take any real number. Say you take X or any real number. This can be written as X plus I into 0. I into 0 will be 0. So X is X. So every this real number can be written in the form of this Z. That is why the statement is true. So X belongs to R implies X belongs to C. X belongs to real number. That means X belongs to the complex number. Then the fifth one is the sets P, which is A. I'll just write you here. P is a set A and B is a set A. But here, see, this P has an element A, but B has an element which is a set. This is a set. This is a set which is here. So this is, they both are not equal. It is false.
They are entirely different stuff.
Next is the sets A, that is, the A set is given as, I'll just read it for you. X is such that X is a letter of word little, and B is X is such that X is a letter of word title. So let me write title title. So it will be title. I'm just removing the repeated one, and let me write little little. Now I'm just striking out those which are repeated. So if you see T is there, L is there, E is there, and I is there. So they are equal. They both sets are equal because they have TILE. Both are made up of TILE characters only. Which of the following statements are correct? So I'll just write those which are correct. Means first write the question. Write a correct form of each of the incorrect statements. So if you find it incorrect, then you have to write the correct one also. First is, A is a subset of A, B, C. No, A is not a subset of A, B, C. A belongs to A, B, C. A is an element of this set. So this is false. A belongs to A, B, C. Next one is given as, let me write it here. It is A belongs to A, B, C. Now this is also false. Why? This is a set. And here we have element A. This set, if we have, say, comma, and I'm writing here, if we have one more element like this, then we can say it belongs. But this is a set, and set, this is an element. So it is not belonging here. It has to be like this so that it belongs. The third one is, A belongs to A, B. Now, A is not belonging here because this is a set. A is an element. A does not belong here. It is a set, right? So A is not belonging here. Neither A is a subset of this one. Neither it is belonging nor it is there. If you write like this, then it belongs. And here, if you want to correct it, just say this one, and then you say this is a subset of ABC because you have taken A out and put a brace. Now it becomes the subset. Now the fourth one is the set of all real numbers. Oh no, fourth one is A, this one. Let me write it for you. A is a subset of A, B. Now this fourth one, if you see, this exactly is here with comma sign. That means this element is exactly here. So it is belonging here, not a subset. If you want to find out the subset of here, you take this element out, and this element is what? It is a set. Then you have to put a brace. Then you say it is a subset of this one. So this is how, this is a subset of this one, but it is not this element is not a subset here. Next one, this like this, B comma C is a subset of A comma B comma C, like this. So B C is a subset of this one. So if you see that B and C, this exact element is here. So it belongs here. It is inside as an element here. So we have to write B and C belongs to this one. Now the sixth one, A comma B is a subset of A comma B comma C. So A comma B is a subset of, see, this is a proper set. We have A and B as two elements, but A is different here. This is an element, and B is an element of this set. So this cannot be equated even. So you just have to say no. Seventh is, phi belongs to A, B. Are you able to see phi here inside? No. It has to be like comma phi, then we say phi belongs here. But it is not there. But phi is in fact subset of every set. So you just have to write this as subsets. This subset you have to write. Phi is a subset of every set. Next one. It is phi is a subset of A, B, C. And I just said that phi is a subset of every set. So this is correct now. This is correct. Next one is x is such that x plus 3 equal to 3 is equal to phi. Is it equal to phi? Let me see. X plus 3 equal to 3. X equal to 3 minus 3. So x is 0. So we have an element 0 in this set. It is not equal to phi. We just have to write not equal to phi. So this is false. Next one is, let A, this set A is given like this. Let A, comma B, comma C, comma D, E. A is like this. Then we have to say whether these statements are false or which of these statements are false and why. The first is C, D is a subset of A. So C, D is belonging here. So it's an element of this set. It is not a subset. If you want to make it a subset, just make like this. Then only it will be a subset. Because this is an element. This is an element. It belongs to A, not it is a subset. So you have to make one more brace. Then you can say, okay, it is a subset. Next is C, comma D belongs to A. Now this is exactly right. Why? Because C, comma D is an element here and it is belonging to A with comma separation. So it is there. It is belonging. Next one is this one only. That is two braces C, comma D is a subset of A. And I told you that when you want to make an element as a subset, you take it out, this is a whole element from here to here, and then you put a brace here, or the curly brackets, and then you say it is a subset. Because set is only formed when you put a brace. Now, next one is the fourth one, which is this one. A belongs to capital A. So A is there, A is an element, so it belongs to A. It is belonging. Next one is A is a subset of A. See, A is an element here. It is not a subset. If you want to make it a subset, you have to do like this. So it is false. Now, sixth one. A, comma B, comma E is a subset of A. So A is there, B is there, and E is there. So it is a subset of A. This is correct. Now we have A, B, E. Belongs to A. So now this is a set, and if you want this to be a to belong here, you have to have exactly this stuff here with comma separation. Here exactly you want this one, then only you say this is belongs to A. So this becomes false. Then we have, this was the seventh one. Now we come to the eighth one, which is A comma B comma C is a subset of A. A comma B comma C is a subset of A. So A, B, oh, C is inside this. This is a complete set. So you cannot say this one. This is false. Then we have phi belongs to A. Same discussion which we had earlier, that you have to have a phi here so that you say that phi belongs here. But it is not belonging. It is not written here. So it is not belonging. And then we have phi is a subset of A. See, phi is a subset of each and every set. But this, when you put a phi here, that means you have to have a phi. Then you take phi out, then you put a brace, then you say it is a subset of A. So this is also false. So this is the exercise 1.4 we are taking, and we'll take there are around 16 questions. So we'll be taking it in the later discussion. Till then, thank you so much. Take care of yourself.